Hi, today we'll be discussing Goa's struggle for freedom. So, Goa came under Portuguese rule in 1510 when Alfonso de Albuquerque had acquired its control from Adil Shah of Bijapur. The famous reverse that took place in Kungkolim in 1583 were Pinto Revolt and Rane Revolt. Pinto Revolt took place in 1787 and Rane Revolt took place in 1852 to 1912. This both revolts were unsuccessful because they lacked broad and active support base and they were localized in nature. People felt Portuguese oppression during Salazar's rule. Oppression means cruel or unjust treatment towards them. Dictatorship of Dr. Salazar. The establishment of this dictatorship in Portugal was the period of repression in Goa. It implemented ecto-colonial, that civil liberties of the people were abolished, censorship of the press was introduced, newspaper coming from other parts of the India was censored, all political parties except the Unão National were banned. Goa Congress Committee, GCC. It was established by Dr. Tristão Braganza Cunha. Objective was to free Goa from the Portuguese rule and integrate her with Mother Earth. Other two members were his two nieces that they joined him later, Bertha de Menezes Braganza and Dr. Beatriza de Menezes Braganza. They took part in civil disobedience movement in 1930 and that created the feeling of nationalism among people. Gomantak Praja Mandal, founded in Mumbai by Dr. Julião Menezes, advocate Luis Mendes, Joaquim Dias and Zotico Souza. It was based on the philosophy of Luis de Menezes Braganza, and they published newspaper Gomantak in English and Romi Konkani. Gomantakiya Tarun Sangha was set up in Margao under the leadership of Shamrao Madkaikar. The aim of that was to have an open discussion on the social and political issue. They organized a Swayam Sevak Dal, opened library, published Marathi periodical Uttejan. Leaders like P.P. Shirodkar and Suryakant Naik celebrated Independence Day with slogans like Vande Mataram at Karmali. Goa Seva Sangh was founded by Purushottam Kakodkar in 1945. It was inspired by Gandhian philosophy. They followed the principle of Satyagraha and Swadeshi. They advocated the spinning of cloth on charkha. They secretly observed the national days and mobilized support for the movement in the villages. Members were Vinayak Mayekar and Nilkant Karapurkar. Other organizations like this were Goa Youth League, Vidyarthi Congress, Rashtra Seva Dal. In 1942, Peter Alvarez and Vishwanath Lavinde had participated in Quit India movement. The movement of 1946. On 18 June 1946, Dr. Lohia arrived at the railway station on Margao. He was greeted with slogans like Jai Hind. After that, he arrived at the open space near municipal building in Margao and he addressed a public meeting to challenge the ban on civil liberties. Once he started with the speech, he was arrested and taken to the Margao police station. Then people flocked in large number at the police station shouting slogans, and because of that, next day Dr. Lohia was taken to Kolam and released. On 18 June it is celebrated as Goa Revolution Day. Also 18 June road in Panjim is remembrance of this event. In September 1946, Lohia returned to Goa and he was arrested and imprisoned at Agwad jail for 10 days. After the 10 days, he was released on the borders of Goa. T.B. Cunha and Purushottam Kakodkar were arrested and deported to Portugal. P.P. Shirodkar was put in Angola jail and Divakar Kakodkar in Cabo Verde. National Congress Goa was established in Londa near Belgium. The president of this was Dr. Ram Hedge. The leaders were Peter Alvarez, Dr. Pundalik Kaitonde, Mark Fernandez, Anthony de Souza and others. They believed in principle of Satyagraha. Azad Gomantak Dal, their intention was to carry out armed struggle against the Portuguese rule. Members were Vishwanath Lavande, Prabhakar Sinari, Balaray Mappari, Rock Santan Fernandez and Mohan Ranade. Goa Vimochan Samiti was established on 1954 and their objective was to liberate Goa from the Portuguese rule. Their headquarters is at Pune. Goa Action Committee was formed in 1953 in Bombay. Then the chairman was Dr. T.B. Kunna. Their aim was to bring all Goan nationalists and chalk out a definite program. Satyagraha of 1954. On 15th August 1954, first Satyagraha in Goa took place. Leaders were Mark Fernandez, Alfred Afonso, Anthony de Souza. There were almost 4,000 to 6,000 participants in this. The effects of this was Portuguese sailed the borders, blasted the bridges, ordered shoot at sites, suspended rail and ferry services and clamped a curfew on Goa. Satyagraha of 1955. On 15 August 1955, they organized a Satyagraha by Goa Vimochan Samiti. In this, 4,000 Satyagrahis participated from Kashmir, Punjab, Bengal, Gujarat, Karnataka, Maharashtra. 32 Indian Satyagrahis were shot dead by Portuguese, including Colonel Singh from Punjab. The members attacked the police station at Mapsa, clashed with the Portuguese soldiers at Pomburfa, raided Kunkolim outpost, disrupted the traffic and cut telephone wires. During attack on Betim police station, Mohan Ranade was wounded and he was imprisoned for 6 years and deported to Portugal. Women who had participated in this was Sindhutai Deshpande, Sudhatai Joshi, Irene Heredia, Maria Clesita Joaquin Arago, Operation Vijay. On 11 December 1961, V.K. Krishna Menon, who was India's defense minister, decided to use military force to liberate Goa from Portuguese rule. This was done by a military operation called Operation Vijay. It was placed under the command of General Chaudhary, directed by Major K.P. General Kedith. Indian troops were dispatched to Belgium, Vapi and Una, instructed to attack Goa, Daman and Diu. On 12 December, main route to Goa was sealed that helped the movement of Indian army. They entered north, east and south. On 19 December 1961, Indian troops arrived at Panjim, that is at the Betim side. At 10 a.m., Major General K.P. Kedin hoisted the Indian national flag, and at 4:30 p.m., Indian soldiers captured Mormugao. Soldiers had occupied Kankona, reached Margao, and captured all government buildings. And on the same day, Portuguese Governor General Venceslau Silva handed political power to Indian government by signing instruction of surrender. And Goa was liberated on 19 December 1961.